guys, hope you're all having a great day so far. Since I did my huge makeup clear out video a couple of months back, I think it was, I have been really, really picky with the makeup that I keep from PR parcels and deliveries. If I get sent 10 makeup items, I'll probably keep one, maybe two. So this is all like the best of the best in my eyes. This is all stuff that I was really excited to try. To begin, I have some foundations from Jouer. So this is the Jouer Essential High Coverage Cream Foundation, Hyaluronic Acid Matte Oil Free. So I've got Alabaster and Porcelain. So now I'm just going to try Alabaster. My little baby is not feeling well today. Oh, you mean me? What's wrong? Ooh, wow, this is definitely, oh, Mimi, what's wrong? This is definitely Marc Jacobs Remarkable Cover FX. Ooh, yeah. It's just like pigment suspended in water. That's what it feels like. Beautiful. A little goes a very long way. Color is good. Yep, good match, really good match. So that's with about one pump, I believe. Really, really nice coverage. Doesn't look cakey because it is so watery. A little went a really, really long way. The color's awesome. So I'm going to apply another layer with a beauty blender and see how that works. So that is with two layers. You can see that my skin has just become another shade lighter. I knew that was impossible. Overall, I think it has aged me a little bit. Most of these watery high coverage foundations unfortunately do. But would I wear it again? Yes. I think it's a really, really nice foundation. What do you guys think? Yay or nay? The BH Studio Pro Total Coverage Concealer Corrector in the shade 101. What a weird applicator. Why is it shaped like that? Ooh, a lot comes out at once. Ooh. Whoa. That is really nice. Like, really nice. This reminds me of the Tarte Shape Tape a little bit, but more so the ColourPop No Filter Concealer and how well it just blends away to nothing. So that is before and after. Just a subtle difference. Whoa, look at these small ones. I've had this in my drawer for so long, but I still haven't used it. I will be using this a lot more frequently. This is amazing. Okay, that really, really impressed me. We are off to a good start, everyone. We're off to a good start. Okay, I've got this Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood Beauty Light Wand Easy Highlighter in the shade Spotlight. And I've used this on the back of my hand before, but not on my face. It's this cool little applicator. I'm going to apply it to the back of my hand and then apply it to my face because I feel like that's going to give me a better result. What I have noticed about this foundation is that it just does not have much glowy luminosity to it. It's very flat. It is almost like identical to the Marc Jacobs Remarkable. So if you have tried that and you didn't like it, I don't think you'll like this. But if you liked it, you'll probably like this. So I'll use my beauty blender, I think is the best way to use it, maybe, hopefully. And just, ooh, that's nice. Ooh, that's really nice. This is the first impression that I've done in a while, that everything so far has gone amazingly. As you all know, I don't really like using cream products because I just feel like I have less control and it pulls up my foundation, which it is actually doing. Oh, you can kind of see there. Okay, maybe I'm just gonna try and apply it with my fingers instead. No, still pulling off the foundation. How do people get around this? I don't understand. There's an actual line where you can see where it's taken off my foundation. I'm doing it. I'm doing it. Okay, it's finally done. I fixed it to the best of my ability. It doesn't look bad. It looks fine. I'm just bummed that that happened because I was on such a good streak of products working amazingly. I still do think I'm going to use this. I might just use it when I have no foundation on, just as a natural kind of, well, natural highlight. How do you guys make cream highlighters on foundation work? Because I swear to God, every single time I use one, the foundation comes off where I apply the cream highlighter, and it's depressing because I want to have a nice like natural glowy dewy face, but it just doesn't want to do it for me. So any tips greatly appreciated. I'm going to set my face with the Fenty Beauty Invisimatte blotting powder in the universal shade, because I haven't actually used this before and I have to set the rest of my face. I'm not usually a fan of using white powders to set my face because a lot of the time they can create a white cast. Obviously when I'm fake tanned, not when I'm fair, because a white cast is usually a good thing. Ooh, that looks nice. Really nice. Doesn't add a white cast, I don't think. And did a nice job of, yep, mattifying my foundation. Awesome. For blush, I'm going to use the Essence Life is a Festival Duo Blush in 01 Hippie Hippie Hooray. So it's a really pretty gradient blush. I'm going to be very light-handed with this and kind of hang around that lighter area rather than a darker area. Ooh, this is a really nice soft color. For highlight, I'm going to use the Tarte Skin Twinkle. Oh, that's so cute. I love that name. Skin Twinkle Volume 2 Lighting Palette. Skin Twinkle, that's so cute. So these shades here, and I'm going to use Daylight. Or should I use, oh, Skylight's just so light. Even though I am so fair at the moment, I still don't like using highlighters that are like paper white. It just doesn't look natural. That's the whole goal here. So I'm going to use Daylight. Even look at that. That is so light. Imagine how light Skylight would have been. It's really weird. It has like a, whoa, it's so intense. It has a, almost like a blue, no, it literally does have a blue tint to it, I swear. Whoa, and that's why it looks so light, because that's a bluish tint. I could just be making that up, but I swear I'm not. It makes sense in my head. Whoa. Yeah, I don't know. I don't really like that. In fact, I don't like that. It's way too bluish, which is so weird because it does not look blue at all in the pan. Look at that. That's so weird. So weird. I'm going to try out this Morphe Nightmaster 15N eyeshadow palette. Now, let me just say, first of all, thank God they improved the packaging. It's so much nicer now. I was always so surprised that they kept that packaging the way it was for so long. Considering it was such a popular brand, I just felt like the packaging didn't reflect what was inside. But this is much nicer. It looks, just feels heavier, nicer, more sturdy packaging. The label, like the font is so much nicer. And the inside is nice as well. So I actually have shade names, which is awesome. I'm going to start off with this one here in the crease. Next, I'm going to use Shook, this one here. It's kind of hard for me to judge these eyeshadows at the moment because the makeup underneath is a bit of a mess from when I had to reapply my foundation. I'm going to use the Stila Written in the Stars Glitter and Glow Liquid Eyeshadow Set. I think this is part of the holiday collection, I believe, but I could be wrong. And I'm going to use this beautiful shade here. Oh, it's so pretty, called Kitten Karma. Now, I don't know how these apply, so I'm hoping they're going to be easy to use. Whoa. Oh my gosh. This is going to be like instant crazy drama. Okay, let's just do it. Oh my God, I'm in, oh, what? I'm in love. Oh my gosh. I think I'm kind of ruining the foil effect by using my finger to blend it out, but I really need to, otherwise it's gonna look stupid. So as nice as that is, I'm actually going to go over with another glitter product because it's so pretty. And I have been wanting to try this for a while. The Natasha Denona Chroma Crystal Top Coat. Apparently meant to be like crystals or something. I don't know, something like that, but I'm just gonna see how it applies to the lid. Okay, I think it's getting a little bit over the top now. Definitely, I've definitely crossed that line, but that's fine. Just gonna cross the line on the other eye as well. Going to use the Natasha Denona. Whoa, damn it, just fell out. That was a really nice color too. Wah. The whole thing just fell out of the pan. Anyway, I'm going to go back in with the Natasha Denona Holiday Eyeshadow Palette in 02 Aries. Eris? and use this shade in the middle just to darken up that lid a little bit. I'm gonna line my lash line with the Tarte Maneater liquid eyeliner. I actually hadn't used this eyeliner before, but oh my god, it's amazing. What? It's so easy to use. It isn't like a little felt tip applicator, which I thought it was. It's almost like, I'm not even sure what it is. It feels like lots of tiny little fine brush hair things shaped into a point. And so it never gets dry. And it was so easy to apply. That was amazing. Oh, 10 out of 10. For mascara, I'm going to try the MAC Bold and Bad Lash. I've never once in my life tried, or have I? I don't think I have tried a MAC mascara, so this will be interesting. It looks like this, and it's got the big brush here and then a smaller one, I'm assuming for your lower lashes. So that top mascara, the big wand, was fine, nice. I had to build it up quite a lot to get it to this point, but still a nice result. Now I'm just going to use the tiny little wand on the lower lashes. Eh, to be honest, I don't really have any feelings about that. I kind of find it annoying, it just takes longer. For lashes, I'm going to use the Tartest Pro lashes. These ones, can you see? Yep, here. In the shade Flirt, or in the style Flirt, with the Red Cherry Eyelash Brush Adhesive. I've never used this one before, so we'll see how it works. These are extremely natural ones. I'm not sure if I'm gonna like them because I don't like natural ones normally. I'm in two minds about these lashes. I need to add some eyeliner to the inner corner to blend the band in, but I'm not sure. Like, I thought I really wouldn't like them that much once I actually pulled them out of the box, but it's just a really, really natural lash that adds length and a little bit of drama. So now I'm on to lips, and I have so many products to try, and I really want to try out this lip product, but I'm going to start off with lip liner first. I'm going to start with the Jouer Long Wear Cream Lip Liner in Sienna. Wow, super creamy. Wow. And I feel like I'm barely even touching my lips. That's really, really nice. It's a little bit darker than I would have liked. Okay, I'm going to use the Lawless liquid lipstick in Cameron. Ooh. Oh, it smells nice. Ooh, it smells like, just like sweet, very sweet. I really like this liquid lipstick. It looks like it's a matte finish, but doesn't feel like it's matte, and when I smile, it hasn't settled into all of my little fine lines, which is why I hate liquid lipsticks. It's really, really comfortable. I love the color. I think I'm gonna love this color a million times more when I have a tan, because it's really nice when I'm fair, which means that it's gonna be even like a really nice creamy light pink shade when I have a tan. So love this color. I'm looking up close at the foundation and it looks beautiful, like really nice, like really nice. And that's saying something considering I butchered it and then tried to fix it and it still looks nice. It just looks very flawless. You can probably see, I mean, what you're seeing in the camera is pretty much what I'm seeing. It looks really nice from far away, as you can see, but also up close. Yeah, it's settled into my lines a little bit, but I mentioned that every single video, every single foundation I've ever tried settles into my lines. I mean, some are worse than others, some are pretty good, and some are pretty bad, but this one is on the better side, I guess. I mean, actually, underneath my eyes is a bit of a mess. My under eye creasing is actually, whoops, that was my Uber Eats order confirming, yes, woo! Anyway, underneath my eyes, it's separated quite a bit, which is a bit of a bummer, but everywhere else, it looks really nice. It's holding the blush beautifully. The highlighter, which may I add, has really nicely settled into my skin. Like it's kind of lost that blue tinge. Oh, actually, you kind of see it is still a little bit bluish, but I'm just really impressed with this foundation. What do you guys think? Do you like these videos? Do you like the kind of tutorial mixed in with the first impressions? What makeup product did you like the most out of this look? just let me know. Leave a comment down below. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And give the video a thumbs up. Whoa, self-promo if you liked the video. So thank you all so much for watching. I love you guys and I hope to see you all in my next video. Bye.